This is The Rundown. I'm Hari Srinivasan. More than 4,000 heat records have been set this year, or broken this year, however you want to look at it. We're joined by Brad Rippey, a USDA agricultural meteorologist. Is that accurate?
That's correct. Yes.
Okay, and so you focus in on, and you're one of the authors of the U.S. Drought Monitor, which is a compendium of 11 different groups that are all studying how bad this heat is and what kind of impacts it has on agriculture, right? So take us through the last 6 or 8 weeks. How bad has it been?
Well, Texas started to get in trouble 10 months ago. So starting in the fall of 2010, right as La Nina began to develop, we started getting in trouble in Texas. Flash forward to just a few weeks ago, and all of a sudden the heat just got out of control in the south central United States. Texas is coming off its hottest, second driest July on record. The new number is just coming in. And you have to go back to 1998 to find the second hottest now for Texas. And 2000 was the only drier July in Texas. So the heat, the dryness of late has just amplified the effects of this 10-month drought.
Wow. So now what kind of impact does that have to a farmer? When you talked about pasture land, that means there's less for the cattle or whatever to graze, right?
Well, there's basically nothing left for cattle. If you're going to maintain a herd of cattle at this point in Texas, you have to bring in hay from outside. There's just no way to support a grass crop with temperatures and drought like it's been. For crops, normally you can irrigate crops like cotton. Cotton's fairly heat tolerant, but this year even irrigated crops are wilting underneath this heat.
So we're talking about longer term economic impacts. If the farmers have to take their cattle to market faster, or if basically do I just give up on my cotton crop or my wheat crop?
Certainly we've already seen this go through two cycles of crops. We virtually lost all of the winter wheat crop in Texas that was planted in the fall of 2010. Now it's really looking like we're going to lose most of the summer crops as well. And very quickly, we're coming up with a calendar where farmers have to decide whether they're going to try to plant the 2011-12 winter wheat crop. And of course, we've seen problems all the way into the southeast. If you look at the 10-month period from October to July, it was the second driest on record in Florida and the third driest on record in Georgia and South Carolina. So we're not just confined to Texas here. This is a drought that now covers more than 30% of the country. And obviously it's been expanding in recent weeks.
Okay, now kind of put your forecasting hat on, since you are a meteorologist. Is this going to get worse?
The troubling thing is that we are now at a situation where the National Weather Service is calling for about a 50-50 chance of a second year of La Nina. And that could prove to be absolutely devastating for the south central U.S. Of course, with La Nina, a cooling of the central and eastern equatorial Pacific waters, that has a downstream effect on the southern United States in the form of the hot, dry conditions that we experience. So if we do see a resurgence of La Nina this fall or winter, that could lead to yet another year of drought for Texas and neighboring areas.
So have you seen it this bad? Are you concerned?
Very concerned because of the expanse of the drought. And really what hits me is the intensity of this drought. We've had drier periods in the 1930s, the 1950s, multi-year dry periods, but we have never seen in Texas a drier 10-month period anytime, going back to record keeping that begins in 1895.
All right, Brad Rippey from the USDA, thanks so much for your time.
All right, thank you.
This is The Rundown. I'm Hari Srinivasan. Stay with us.